back on the hill here in Worcester. We welcome you to the Heart Center as the Holy Cross Crusaders return home from a road trip to RIT to take on the Merrimack Warriors here on Tuesday night. Alongside Jim Conley, my name's David Korzanowski. And Jim, both of these teams' coaches say that they're better than their records show, and one thing that they're going to need to do to improve in this second half of the season is tighten up defensively.
You know what? Defensively, and particularly in net.
Right.
You know, you look at all of the available goaltenders tonight have save percentages below 90%. That doesn't cut it in college hockey. So I think you'll see two goaltenders that are hungry in net tonight, but at the same time, they know that their coaches are waiting for somebody to take charge in that net.
Yeah, and it's the Merrimack Warriors who have more offense than in years past. A huge reason why is because of Max Newton, the captain who leads the team in points.
You know what? Transfer from Alaska in the WCHA, the old WCHA, and, you know, this kid came in and has had an impact right away. 6 goals in 12 games. This is a kid with 27 goals in his collegiate career. He really makes that top line for Merrimack go. They need him to perform offensively.
Yeah, he scored a pair against Maine a couple weeks back in the first game of that series. On the other side, the story for the Crusaders this year has been the emergence of the junior defenseman, Nick Hale. He has 10 assists on the season.
Yeah, and Bill Rieger calls him a great skater with a lot of skill, a very competitive player. And he feels like that he has brought this team to a different level, particularly getting some offense from the blue line.
He's riding a 4-game point streak and has recorded 2 assists in his last 3 games. Hale versus Newton, Crusaders versus Warriors coming up here at the Heart Center after this. Felton's 4th penalty of the season, 2nd power play of the night for Holy Cross. They're 0-for-1 today, and they have 11 power play goals on the season. 2nd in their conference in power play goals. Big shot from Hale is blocked in front by Welshner. Hale moves it to the outside. Back to Hale at the point. Hale swings it to the right to Liebold. Back up top to Hale. Goes to the left. Shot. And a save by Olas. Cicero had a chance. Liebold in front. And it's tapped in by Ricketts. Holy Cross has cut the deficit to just 1. Jeffries to Carlisle at the point. To Jandrick. This is the first power play unit for Merrimack. Jandrick shoots, deflected in front, goes out, and Slick will wind up, and that puck will bounce all the way back, but Carlisle does a great job to keep it in. Carlisle to his left to Newton, back to Carlisle. Big shot deflected by Liebold, and he is down in a little pain. Pops right back up, though. Hit his right leg quite hard. Jandrick now. Carlisle, Jeffries. Jeffries creeping in, and another block by Liebold. And Slick will clear this one, no problem.
Yeah, we talked about this Holy Cross penalty kill. They like to take up the lanes. They want to block shots. They want to block passes. And Liebold did it right there in spades. And
Coach Scott Borick saying that the penalty kill has to improve for Merrimack. They let up 2 crucial power play goals to Maine that tied the game up at 3 on Friday a couple weeks ago. Maine eventually winning 6-5 in overtime. Could be the same story here if Holy Cross can convert. Shot deflected well high and out of play off of Tyler Brown with 46 seconds left.
Well, I can tell you that what Merrimack is doing right now in this penalty kill is solid. I mean, they're positionally always in the right spot. They've taken away a lot of shooting lanes. Holy Cross needs to get a little bit more patient. Maybe some of those deke shots can help a little bit. But, you know, what Merrimack is doing is just being fundamentally strong on a penalty kill.
Fans here would love to see another power play goal for the Crusaders. They scored 1 earlier in the second after Merrimack scored 2 in the first period. Here's Higgins. Higgins on the left point, skates towards the center. Peterson drops it back behind goal. Back up top to Giardozzi. Winding up is Higgins. Backhand shot. Olas smothers it. And again, another good chance for Holy Cross. Now Mike Brown, big hit from behind by Liebold. Tracked down by Dolan. Dolan in the corner to the near side to Shatsky. Shatsky, the freshman, up ahead for Young. Young moves in, tries to turn the corner, stood up by Brown. Young has it again. Bobby Young goes all the way around, shoots one in front, can't find Constable. Backing out of the zone. batted down by Slick. Nice play by the captain, and McNabb quickly takes it over for Holy Cross. Big shot from outside the blue line. Young will chase it. Young deep in the corner. Walsh. Walsh now up for Robilotti. Carlson Tagstrom, odd man rush if they hurry. Pops out. Walsh back for Forsberg, and he scores. Philip Forsmark's second of the game, and Merrimack's back up two. Penalty killing unit was third in the Atlantic Hockey Association coming into this game, and they've been perfect so far tonight. 30 seconds left on the man advantage as Newton drops it back for Jandrick. Jandrick gains the zone. Jandrick, full head of steam far side, stood up by Robilotti. Loose. Merrimack wins the puck. Carlisle over to his right to Jeffries. Jeffries with the shot. Blocked in front. Backhanded back to the blue line. Carlisle now. Another shot. Saved by Gordon. Robilotti. Jeffries now. And poked away by Colabuffo. That should do it for the third power play of the night for Merrimack. Bobby Young. Bobby Young to the outside. Back to Young. Young backhand shot. Ola, second chance, and another save. Out to the right wing circle. Shot blocked. Pops over for Thorne on the left side. Hale tracks it down. Hale wins the puck. Hale back to Cicero. Cicero left wing circle between the circles. Gets a shot off. It's gloved down, but pops out. Peterson trickles in. And Holy Cross pulls within one with 4:05 left. First goal of the season for Peterson. Hugo Olas, 17 seconds away from his second win of the season. His first came against Colgate when he let up two goals and had 30 saves. Holy Cross wins the faceoff. It's Ricketts. Now Liebold is in the corner. 12 seconds left. 10. It's loose in front. And it's Liebold. Liebold has it. They got to get a shot off. Liebold to his right. Hale winds up and it's blocked. Big block by Ben Brar with 1 second left. Last ditch effort is blocked by Carlisle, and Merrimack hangs on for a one-goal win. What a great finish, Jim.
It was, you know.